Today we find out that apparently we've taken one big step closer to nuclear fusion being able to be used as an actual power source. Now it's a step that still leaves us many steps away from actually being able to do that, but it's an important one. And Energy Secretary Jennifer Granholm is expected to announce this at some point today. The breakthrough that they'll be talking about apparently came in the past 2 weeks at the National Ignition Facility of the federal Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory in California. And so here's what they did. In a brief moment lasting less than 100 trillionths of a second, 2.05 megajoules of energy, roughly the equivalent of a pound of TNT, bombarded a hydrogen pellet. Out flowed a flood of neutron particles, the product of fusion, which carried the energy equivalent of about 1.5 pounds of TNT, or an energy gain of about 1.5. So historically, this is the first time that a nuclear fusion experiment has produced more energy than was put into the actual experiment, which is obviously necessary for this to be able to be used as a source of energy. And the reason that this is something that scientists have been working on around the globe for literally decades is that nuclear fusion, which is the fusion of two atoms rather than the breaking apart of an atom, doesn't produce dangerous radioactive waste like traditional nuclear energy and is theoretically virtually unlimited in supply. Again, it's theoretical because this was laboratory conditions. It required, I believe, 192 lasers, including one of the largest lasers in the world. And so this is very far from being able to be scaled up to industrial use, to be able to be spread throughout the globe. And I have concerns about a focus on this technology, which is still very much in its early steps. But River, what do you think about this? It's a historic thing.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, I guess the first thing I would say is, what the heck is a megajoule? That's a Back to the Future reference for anybody that's not as old as me. I try to look at the positives, you know, that this is, you know, more energy coming out than going in. But my personal beliefs in terms of power is looking the other way around, as opposed to trying to create giant forms of power. Perhaps reducing our usage is the path forward. Personally, but trying to stay positive, it's not creating nuclear waste. That's positive. If we're gonna keep doing this, that's great. I still haven't watched Chernobyl, and I probably won't. So
it's a great show. I would recommend.
I'm sure it's a great show.
I might rewatch it actually. Yes. So look, this if they can scale it up, it can be great. Virtually limitless, largely emission-free energy around the globe would be an amazing thing, let alone there are implications for long-range space exploration. This has a lot of benefits over other ways of making energy. So that's definitely true. And I am perfectly fine with many scientists working on this around the globe. What I would say is, while we should stop and acknowledge the amazing, the product of decades of international effort that went into this, that is very good. Love to see that. Do not stake all of your hopes for dealing with climate change on something that will not, if ever, be ready to go until after we're decades more into the climate crisis. We already have all the technology we need to deal with the climate crisis, at least in large part. There is renewable energy zapping us in the face everywhere on the globe right now. We just need to harness it, let alone the wind and hydro power and thermal energy and all of that. We should be pursuing all of that. And if someday those get surpassed by nuclear fusion, I think that would be a great thing. But if we work hard enough and put in the time and the effort and the investment, we might not need the nuclear fusion, because there's always gonna be wind and there's always gonna be sun. We can cross that fusion bridge when we get to it. But I would hate to see politicians and governments and regular people ignore the work that can and needs to be done right now by just looking ahead to technology that might not be ready until our grandkids' days. Anyway, any other thoughts before we close the show?
I agree. I mean, it's like only electric cars and not public transportation. We got to do both things, and we can't just look at the pie in the sky of this like nuclear fusion thing that's not going to happen for 40 years, 50 years, 60 years. I don't know. I again leave you with, what the heck is a megajoule? You know what I mean?
And when are they going to start producing gigawatts?
That's right. Give me a gigawatt.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.